I was sent the weirdest thing the other day, a levitating Death Star speaker. With the new Star Wars movie coming out, I feel like now would be a good time to take this thing apart, unbox it, and see what kind of force it uses to levitate. Let's get started. And peel off the top. And inside, we probably have some kind of instruction books, a little bit of foam padding, and, oh boy, the Death Star. The Bluetooth speaker inside of the set. And I think at the very bottom, we have this. This should be the base. Oh, got a little bit of a force there. Here in the center, it wants to pull the base off to the side like that. Okay, let's see what happens. I'm not sure what this thing is. Maybe those instructions were important after all. When you feel a strong force, which is holding the Death Star from the base, this position is the levitation point. Release the speaker gently and take out the floating stand vertically without any impact on the Death Star. Okay, let's try that out. So I'm gonna take both hands, trying to find the floating point here in the center. Oh boy, I think I got it. Nice. Woo! Okay. The Death Star is now levitating. Come take a look at this. It is spinning all by itself, and there is nothing below it. That's pretty sweet. List of available devices right here is the Death Star. We'll go ahead and pair with that. The only proper way to start off a Bluetooth Star Wars speaker is with 10 hours of the Cantina Band. It's not bad. I mean, it's a small speaker, so it's not gonna have the big bass of a big speaker. But it's pretty unique. It's not bad at all. All right. It's very unique. It's a small Bluetooth speaker. If you're gonna buy this, you're gonna buy it because it's Star Wars and not because of the impeccable sound quality. As far as like the levitation goes, it's holding itself pretty well in the air. I mean, above anything, so like there's nothing supporting it. It's rocking around a little bit. I'm curious to see where the mounting points are inside of this thing, like where the force is that's holding it up. And there's only one way to do that. Let's take it apart. Now, destroying the Death Star is actually a pretty big pain. It's almost like it's not designed to come apart. There are no clasps that come undone. Excessive force might be necessary. After analyzing the construction, I have detected a weakness in the battle station, but the approach will not be easy. I will maneuver my saw blade straight down this little trench, right between the power button and this antique micro USB port. Since the Death Star existed a long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away, we can let the micro USB slide for now. But any future Death Stars will need to be equipped with USB-C. These little metal windows can pop out once the plastic surrounding them is cut. You can see how strong the attracting magnetic force is below the Death Star. Finally, I was able to chop through a few of the support channels, which are about the size of a small womp rat. We get a glimpse of the main speaker at this point. It's a small little guy, but it does get the job done. There's a few more screws holding down the speaker to the base. I'll pop those out and continue on to the reactor core. The speaker has three connections, one for the charging port, one for the power button, and the black and red speaker wires themselves. The circuit board has its own four screws. I'll take out those. And finally, the board and battery can come loose from the super weapon. The battery is about 1,000 milliamp hours. The magical force that supports the Death Star is, well, a magnet. It's big, circular, and very tightly glued to the bottom plastic. Pretty interesting. And now it's time to inspect the Empire's foundation. This large circular platform is protected by a thick rubber mat. I imagine this is to help keep the whole thing from moving around. There are four screws under that mat holding the base together. There has to be something super important in here to help keep the Death Star stable. Balancing free-floating magnets is not an easy task. There are some interesting circuits inside the base, with four screws holding it all down to the plastic. After removing these, I can lift up the circuits and flip over the whole contraption, exposing the electromagnets. Electromagnetic levitation is complex, but essentially provides a balance to the force. The large exterior circle you see is a magnet, and the four circles in the center are the electromagnets, usually oriented in the opposite directions, because opposite poles attract. The magnet inside the Death Star is attracted to the large circle-shaped magnet, which makes it kind of hard to place, but the oppositely oriented electromagnets are doing the calculated repelling as needed. turning off and on or adjusting the power to keep the Death Star stable. Remember, this base is plugged into the wall and needs power to keep functioning. Magnets aren't going to float by themselves. Pretty fun stuff, and a major thumbs up to whoever designed this Death Star. I'll leave a link for this contraption in the video description, and now you won't need to take apart your speaker to find out how it floats or how it works. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, and come hang out with me on Instagram. Thank you a ton for watching, and may the Force be with you.